The last step in the chest examination anteriorly is the auscultation. As we have learned, the stethoscope consists of a proximal part, which are the earpieces, and distal part, which is the diaphragm and bell. Some suggest to auscultate the chest with the bell, but the traditional way is to auscultate with the diaphragm. We have a few points should tell the patient about them. First of all, I should tell the patient that he should take and exhale and inspire a breath from his mouth rather than the nose. Not so fast and not so slow, not so deep. And during the auscultation, you have to auscultate the areas in the anterior chest and in the axilla, and try to avoid 2 to 3 centimeters from the midline. And as we have learned in the percussion, the lower chest border should be the 6th rib anteriorly and the 8th rib in the axilla, because as we know, these are the border or lower borders of the lung, below which we will have the diaphragm and the abdominal content, in which the breath sound may be altered, or there may be even bowel sound. In the following way, I'll direct the stethoscope anteriorly the earpieces so as to fit properly with my external auditory meatus in such a way, and I'll tell the patient about these instructions. بس حماد هسه حاليا راح اشيك صدرك بالسماعة. اريدك تاخذ نفس وذبه من حلقك مو من خشمك، مو كلش سريع ولا كلش بطيء، بحالتك لأدي أدي بس شوية أكثر منها. ومن أقول لك أنا أوكي تقدر شوية تدير نوتشك هيك عشتيدة. First of all I'll auscultate over the apices. هسه خذ نفس وذبة قوي، هسه خذ نفس وذبة بعد عشتيدك بعد 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 After that, once you finish the auscultation, you have to check for vocal resonance. It is as the same as the vocal apparatus, with the exception that here we will use the stethoscope instead of the palmar surface of both hands in the following way. قول 44 and so on. You have to continue all these areas. Really, in the auscultation of the chest, you have to put in your minds the following way. That's to say, you have to present your finding in the following manner. First of all, you have to know whether the air entry in both lungs are good, poor, or reduced. This is one. Second, you have to check the breath sounds, whether it is vesicular or bronchial, or vesicular breathing with a prolonged expiratory phase. And the third one, check whether or not the patient had any adventitious or added sound in the form of wheezes, crackles, pneumothorax click, and pleural rub. Let's take a look really about the breath sounds. We have the following breath sound. When you hear the chest of the patient, I'll draw it or show it now. We have the first one, in which there is full inspiratory phase, third expiratory phase with no gap. This is vesicular breathing. The second type of breathing is that of full inspiratory phase, gap, and full expiratory phase. This is bronchial breathing. And the third type is vesicular breathing with a prolonged expiratory phase, in which there is an inspiratory phase, full, and then expiratory phase that is prolonged. This is vesicular breathing with a prolonged expiratory phase. This usually occurs in COPD and asthma. Bronchial breathing occurs, for example, in patient with fibrosis consolidation collapse, and this should be the normal breath sounds over all the lung tissues. really when you hear an added sound, you have to check the following issues. First of all, if you had an added sound in the form of crackles, you have to check whether the crackles are inspiratory or biphasic. If it is inspiratory, you have to check whether it is early inspiratory, middle inspiratory, or late inspiratory. Early inspiratory, for example, occur in patients with bronchiolitis, while a patient with pulmonary edema may develop middle inspiratory phase crackles, while those who develop late inspiratory crackles may have, for example, lung cavities, lung abscess, lung fibrosis. Those who have coarse crepitation or coarse crackles may have bronchiectasis, for example. Once you detect a crackles, you have to put your stethoscope upon the chest and ask the patient to cough, because sometimes at the lung apices, crackles, fine crackles, are normal. This is all about the crackles. About the wheezes, once you check the wheeze, you have to know the mechanism of the origin of wheeze. This is one. You have to know about it, the pathophysiology. And then you have to check whether the wheezes are inspiratory, expiratory, or biphasic. This is one. Second, you have to check whether the wheezes is polyphonic or monophonic. That's to say, having just single type of tone or variable types or variable tones, what we call it polyphonic. This is two. The third one, you have to check whether the wheezes are altered with the coughing or not. And then about the wheeze, you have to know whether it is high-pitched or low-pitched wheeze. Really, about whether it is low-pitched or high-pitched wheeze and whether it is polyphonic or monophonic, these are mainly designated for postgraduate candidate, while the undergraduate student candidate should know just about the wheeze, about the mechanism behind their origin. This is one. And whether the wheezes are expiratory, inspiratory, or biphasic, and whether or not it is altered with the cough. And really, this depends upon the guidelines provided in their college or in their medical school. All these issues and techniques are about the auscultation of the chest anteriorly.